Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's just bow in prayer as we begin. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. We bless your name. Father, we bless you today, God. We thank you, God, that this is the day you have made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it today. We thank you, God, and we can celebrate, God, the life of Sister Julie this evening. We thank you, God, for the life that she has lived, for the example that she has set, God, for her family, for her neighbors, for her friends today. And we pray, mighty God, that you would just move in this place, minister by your Spirit, God. Speak to the hearts of those that are here and those under the reaches of our voices. In the name of Jesus, Lord, intervene by your Spirit, God. Comfort the family today. Give them grace in this time of pain and bereavement. I just pray for strength for every one of them, God. Cover them with your precious blood, God. And I declare your will be done. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. He's a great and mighty God today. Amen. And we know for the believers, the Bible says to be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. Amen? Amen. So let us stand. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus is the winner man today. So it may seem like she lost, it may seem like she was defeated, but she's the winner today. Amen. Amen. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
It's a fantasy, a fantasy. They can lose. It's a fantasy, they can lose. Jesus, the winner man, the winner man, the winner man. Jesus, the winner man, the winner man, the winner man.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! We
already being poured out like a drink offering. And the time for my departure is near. I have fought the good fight, and I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteousness, judge. The award to me on that day, and not only to me, but also for all who have longed for his appearing.
The life of our family is born. The voice we love is still. A place is become in the heart, in the home. Which never can be built. We have to mourn the loss of one we would love to keep. But God, who surely loved to the best, has finally made us sleep. After a lifetime of our love and joy,
thank you so much, thank you so much. So I'm now going to welcome Biology. Yes, welcome. We're going to answer the rest of the policy.
Papa, Ramakut, Papa, Ramana, touch my head.
Today, I say a special thank you to Papa.
Jill loved the party, and most of all, dance. I remember every Friday night, she would ensure we had our dinner, and then she was out. It was through lining and partying that she met her present husband, Michael, also known as Sanchez. He and his daughter, Sonia, was then permanent part of our lives. She then moved to my tower tower for a couple years, until she had her leg amputated. Losing her leg hit the entire family hard. We were shattered. Mommy was a hustler. She loved to dance. How can we ever move on from this, we asked. But being the strong, resilient woman she was, she soon showed us that an amputated leg was not going to stop her. In a short time, we cheered on. Mom was cooking, washing, cleaning, and still doing odd jobs like ironing. Everyone who knew her was in awe of her strength and resilience. Even her Friday night rituals didn't stop, as her pussy, or Tika, Brenda, Barney, Sharon, Edmund, and Dajima would come, pick her up, and head to their city bar, or wherever they like us. Even the dancing never stopped, as she would sit in the wheelchair and dance. The remaining half of her leg always in the air. Jill was known firstly for the love she shared. She loved her children and grandchildren dearly, and would physically fight for us if she had to. She loved each of us in a unique way that we each thought that we were the favorite. She would give us her last and do her best even if we didn't ask. She would call her grandchildren one by one, stuff some crumpled money into their hands and say, put this away faster and don't let the others come again. Give you my fondest memory of her is when I was around 8 and out of school for some reason. She would take me with her to her domestic cleaning job at Algico in San Juan on the West Bay. While she swept, mopped, and wiped desks, I sat in the office chairs and spun until I was dizzy. She would then take me into the office kitchen and make me tea with plenty of condensed milk as I requested. She then collected her $80 for her day's work, and we would head straight to Royal Pasadena Arena, where I would get my very own box of a drumstick and fry. While enjoying my very, very rare treat, she would then issue me a stern warning. Don't say nothing about it to the others, eh? At those times, I cherished the one-on-one times with her, and I felt like she was all mine, and I didn't need to share. Each of my siblings, nieces and nephews, have similar stories where her acts of love for them was unique. Her love didn't stop with her children. She would move mountains for sisters, siblings, nieces and nephews. Her sister Jennifer spoke of many times when she was in trouble and she had to go for Jill as backup, who was always ready to fight. She often stepped in for Jennifer in her absence, caring for her children, Dana, Jason, Marvin, and Janelle, who often referred to her as their next mom. Mommy was by far his favorite auntie. Although her home was humble, many times we had to share beds with someone who mom was helping out. The amount of places or families that mom took in are too many to list. Jill shared her love with strangers, and very soon her favorite quote was, "Love you," which she would utter to almost anyone who crossed her path or assisted her in any way. One day I said, "Mom, how are you telling me this love her? You know her from anywhere?" To which she replied, "God is love." The second thing Jill was known for is her mouth. I'll give you a little joke. The evening she passed, a friend, while trying to lighten the mood, said, "You better play my new play." Not familiar with the numbers and symbols, we decided on Queen, Dead Man, Old Lady, Sick Woman, House. You know what play? House. I laughed loud and wondered how I could forget Jill Mount. Even as the condolence messages were coming in, many of them echoed the same sentiments. R.I.P. Hot Mount Jill. Her voice was also prominent on CT15, as not a day would pass without you hearing, "This is Jill from Malabar." She would then go on to pick up each of her children and grandchildren by name, her neighbors, friends, and even fellow frequent callers. A strong friendship of strangers who never met was formed, which included the other frequent callers, like Twiggy, Jason from the drum, Beatrice, Mr. and Mrs. Cole, Pat, etc. Every single function we attended, we had one rule: to not pass the mic to tech teachers. But then, she would either be the loudest singer, loudest speech maker, or was going to embarrass you in some way. She was brave and outspoken. As her health deteriorated in February of this year, it was sad to see such a strong, determined woman become dependent on others for even the most minor daily tasks. She fought hard, and when she couldn't fight, we encouraged her, and she held on for us. Eventually, it became too much for her to bear, and oftentimes she claimed she was ready, to which we replied, only God was ready, and he's not ready yet. But your case is coming out April 2021 at approximately 2 p.m. He was finally ready, and he called his sweet daughter home. To each of you gathered here today, both physically and virtually, I know you feel some degree of pain in her passing, but I urge you to find peace in knowing that she's no longer suffering, no longer in pain, and I'm certain that she's in the presence of the Lord, because she ensured that she got baptized a couple of years ago and lived for the Lord since. After her amputation, she began to fellowship right here at Hope and Healing Ministry under the leadership of Pastors Ricky and Marlene, since it was close to home and wheelchair accessible. On a Sunday morning, if you pass, you can hear Jill's voice over the PA singing the loudest, and we can even stay at home and hear her singing. The outpouring of love and support came in many ways after her passing, and I am in awe of all the love received. Her father, sisters, nieces and nephews in the U.S. send their love and gratitude to you all. I would like to close again with the scripture, 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7. I have fought a good fight. I have finished my course. I have kept the faith. My mother has fought a good fight. She has finished her course, and she has kept the faith. And now she has gone to be with her heavenly Father, who is in heaven. Rest well, my queen. We love you. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. As you told your lady on the department with your friends who have been in the chairs, but right now the police city, we are overcrowded, with you mentioned earlier, so we want to ask you just to kindly just step back out and we have more choice as well. So what is the position? The police will step in front of you. As you mentioned earlier on, and we want to talk about the people. Thank you very much. Those of you who are the intent, you don't have to move, please.
Oh,
Praise the Lord. Let us clap for her. She is what the Lord? A hand. Right. So we thank God for the hand this evening. The Holy Spirit is doing the job, right? So you know, we have no control over that. Amen. We have no control. So God is good, you know. Jill was always a person in the ministry that was very active. Even though she had just one good dad in that supper, when I had to go away, like go to Ireland to mission trip, I think, I could rest assured, I could leave Jill to manage the worship team. I told the church Tuesday, I don't know who I will have now, because some of them are bashful. But I want to thank God for Jill and the spirit that she gave, not just to this ministry, but to the kingdom of God. So we just, I just want to do this song. And then we have to do the song. The song is, I will run to you. I want to admonish you to run to him. Amen.
Your eyes on
Lord, let you
She run it in spite of all that she faced, all the dilemmas, all the trials, all the testing times in her life. She run to the end and she run well. We bless you, God. We bless you. So let's put that together. Say, welcome, Pastor Ricky. God bless you as you come to minister God's name. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Almighty God, we continue to thank you for your goodness, and we thank you, God, for your mercy. We thank you, God, and being the Lamb of the living. We thank you, God, even this very moment and what we are experiencing. It is bitter and it is sweet. Lord God, why today we have lost a mother, we have lost a friend, a neighbor, a family. But Almighty God, we know that heaven have gained another soul, another person who have run long and have run hard for you, God. We declare you as the God of all comfort. We speak the peace of God that passes all understanding, that will continue to keep our heart and our mind in you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. You can kindly receive for those of you that are sitting. Amen. Again, we wanted to thank you for being here this afternoon. We share our deepest condolences to Sister Jill's family, her children, her neighbors, her friends, those who are here and those who are abroad. And she truly will be missed. And she has been like a big sister to me. I just want to just share this story with you. I can remember in my teenage year, yes, I worked in a farm, that was my first job. And I met Sister Jill and one of her older sisters. And many years have passed, I probably have forgotten Jill. But as she began to fellowship here with us, we began to reminisce, and I told her from Ocean, from Samara, but it's already inside, in Madabanao. And she said, she used to work in a certain farm, and that giant farm in Samara inside, and then I remember her. And as the weeks and the years and the months have passed by, Sister Jill came here and fellowship with us, we became closer, and truly a friend, and I consider her as one of my big sister. I want to let the family know that, and even the children, and even though some of you we have meet on a regular basis and some not on a regular basis, on behalf of my wife and myself, we want to know that we really appreciate you all. And even through the time that we have fellowship with Sister Jill, you all have never stopped showing us your appreciation, even Sister Jill cousin. And we want to thank God for this. It is truly an honor of us to stand with you and to share on today. Amen? We want to declare the word of God according to Ephesians chapter 2, that God grace and God peace and God mercy be with us. God is truly the God of comfort. And as I share with you all on Friday night, is that when we lose a loved one, a mother, father, we don't be on the eve of Mother's Day, we'll always remember this. But the only way we can really and truly deal with grief is to grieve. Amen? The only way we can deal with the loss of someone is when we go through the process of grieving. But the Word of God is here to remind us and to encourage us in the midst of a time of grief. And encourage you at the days, at the weeks, and even the months, and in some cases, yes, it will go through a process, but God, who is the God of all comfort, will continue to bring comfort to you. The portion of scripture which we read before you is the text that we take it from the book of 2 Timothy, chapter 4 and verse 6. And it tells us, "For I am already being poured out like drink offering, and the time of my departure is near." Who have said those words? Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul have labored long and have labored hard for the Lord. Many times he has closed that experience, but he has survived it. But here it is, he was writing to his understudy Timothy and sharing some truth with him. And while he was writing or penning this letter, this book of 2 Timothy and 1 Timothy and many of the other books of the Bible, they are letters. And while he was penning that word, he knew that the time of his departure was near. Most of us may not have such experience that before we die, we can know that we will die. And there are three areas that Paul has shared to Timothy, and I will touch on it briefly. One is fight, finish, and faith. Fight, finish, and faith. And as Paul, who being a Roman citizen, he understands the dynamics of the Roman Empire. And he understands that an empire did not reach there because of being reluctant or slothful. But they reached there as being a superpower in that day and time because there were people who can fight. And by the word of reality, and I remember at one time we were preparing for one of our programs in the church, for one of our anniversary. And besides Sister Church being part of our worship team and being a worshiper, she would work with us even with the children. We have every child is a winner. But then in certain occasion we had honoring the elderly. And one time we were preparing for honoring the elderly, and she was part of our design and decoration department. And she stood up right in the back there, and she was telling us some of the experience and some of the fight. I don't know going into details, and I don't call the name, remember people? And some of the fight she had been in. And when we look at life, life always have a fight. We will never be out of a fight in life. For the parents who have to prepare the child for SEA, it is a fight. For the teacher who right now has to teach children to virtual teaching, it is a fight. For those of us who will work hard and get our subject and our degree, and then we end up in the workplace, it is still a fight. It seems that life always has a fight. Amen. And even though you choose not to fight, then you are still a fight will still come your way. Amen. So when Paul was writing to Timothy, Paul came to a conclusion. After all that was said and done, he said, I have fought a good fight. Amen. Amen, people. I have fought, I have fought a good fight. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Paul had many adversaries. Amen. For those of you probably could see what is happening there, this is one of our champions, Claude Noel. My brother had the opportunity of working with him many years ago. And I also had the opportunity in some of his, before he passed, used to go by him and minister and share the gospel of Jesus. And truly, even at time, even at his retired state, because that's not even at a retired state, he was always a fighter. Amen. Life will always give you a fight. For some of us, in our teenage years, we had lost a fight. Some of us in our 20s, in our 30s, in our 50s, in our 60s, and we could go on and on. It will always have a fight. There will always have a fight that will come your way. But the Bible reminds us, our fight is not against flesh and blood, but our fight is against principalities and powers and spiritual wickedness in high places. But the fight I want to emphasize on is not just a physical fight, but I want to emphasize on the spiritual fight. The problem and the situation that you and I may face, sickness and disease, disappointment, broken heart, broken dreams, these are spiritual problems. And sometimes we try to fight it with a physical fight. But God is saying to you this evening, amen, I am able to fight with you and fight for you. So Paul said, as he concluded, I have fought a good fight. Timothy, he said, I have finished the race. In the Roman culture, the very first Olympic took place in Athens. And Paul was also a spiritual race. And as we know, in 1976, Henry Crawford had won the gold medal. Amen. And our nation was very proud of that achievement. But we want to look at another race. The race that Henry Crawford had won. He really bring a pride back to Trinidad. But the race I want to speak about is a spiritual race. The Bible reminds us that the race is not for the swiftest, but the perish, but for those who endure to the end. When we look at the disease of our sister, our mother, our friend, our neighbor life, in the midst of all that she was going through, she understands that she was running a race. Even during that time, I had many discussions with her. But one time I began to share with her, and I said, Sister Jim, the word of God reminds us, when the outward man perish, the inward man will be renewed. And what God is saying, at times we may go through sickness. Sometimes we may receive healing and deliverance. Sometimes we may die. But in the midst of the sickness, we will continue to run for the Lord. That we have hope not in this life alone. The Bible reminds, if we have hope in this life alone, we're most miserable. But we have hope in the life to come. It don't matter how we go out, how fast or how slow, but what is important that we will keep the faith. When we look at our sister, our mother, our friend, our neighbor, she has kept the faith, no matter what the history was. But she died in Christ. She died looking unto Jesus as the author and the finisher of the faith. As I conclude this afternoon, I conclude with the word of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But before I reach that, the Bible tells us that Paul said that he knew that there is a crown of righteousness is in store for him in heaven. He knew that all that have been through in this life, the up, the down, the shipwreck, the hurt, the pain, the peril, at times people tried to assassinate him, at times he came before the Roman government and Roman authority. But through it all, he knew that there is a reward beyond this life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He said there's a crown of righteousness for those who love the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The 1977 Penny, the very first black woman in history, have won Miss Universe. Hallelujah. And again, as Trinidadian, hallelujah, thank you. And what God is saying to us, the crown that Penny won, we really appreciate it. But God is saying for those of us who anticipate his coming, those of us who anticipate working and laboring for him while today, there's a crown of righteousness. And Jesus tells us in John chapter 14, he said, do not let your heart be troubled. You believe in God. Believe also in me. My Father's house have many mansions. If it had not been so, I would have told you. I am going there to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you with me, that you may be with me where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going. And then Thomas said unto him, Lord, we do not know the way. And he asked Jesus to show us the way. And Jesus answered, I am the way, and the truth, and the life. And no man cometh unto the Father but by me. There's a place that the Lord has prepared for the disease of our sister, our mother, our friend, our neighbor. But there's also a place where the Lord also prepared for you and me. And that place is heaven. Hell is real, But time will not permit us to share with them this morning, this evening. But heaven is also real. And the way to go to heaven, Jesus said it. He said, he did not say, I am one of the way, but I am the way. I am the only way. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man can go to the Father but but by me. Let us just stand for those of you who are sitting. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you, Lord, for your word, God. We thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your mercy. I declare, let the word of God and the hope and the authority of the word of God this evening bring comfort. If you really want to see Sister Jill, to believe that she has made it into the kingdom of God, the Bible tells us to be absent from this body is to be present of the Lord. If you really want to see again, follow the person she has followed, the person of the Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You want to take this time just to pray for the family. Right where you are, you can stand, those of you who are here and those of you who are outside. I want to pray for those who are mourning, of the friends, and you truly appreciate for those of you who have been praised in clement weather and is here this afternoon. We want to thank God even for Brother Perry Shea, who have given us the permission to hold and to do this time of celebrating as we celebrate Sister Jill life. Almighty God, we thank you. The Lord remind us to be absent from this body. It's the presence of the Lord. We thank you, Lord, for such hope that you have prepared a place for us already. We pray, God, for those who are mourning this afternoon, especially Sister Jill children, the grandchildren, the great grandchildren, the friends, the family, the relatives, those who are near, those who are far, neighbors, and relatives, and those who are living in such a personal way, and some more for a short time, some more for a long time, God. But we ask you are the God of all comfort, to bring comfort to all of us, God. Even our church family, bring comfort to me also, God. We declare, God, that you will blow upon us right now a spirit of comfort, God. Lord, as the days will go by, as we approach Mother's Day on Sunday, God, it will be a different Mother's Day for her children, my God. But we are asking you, God, in the name of Jesus, only you and your Lord can truly bring comfort and bring release to those of us who are mourning right now. There are those of us who, even in this congregation and even in the world and out of the reach of my voice, may be struggling with different problems and situations, God. We are asking for your supernatural intervention, God. But we ask you, God, at this time, comfort us, God. We declare your peace that passes all understanding. But keep our heart and keep our mind in Christ Jesus. And Father, we thank you in Jesus' wonderful name of prayer. Amen. We will not do the commencement of the body now because I'm going up to the cemetery and we do that at the cemetery. Amen? So this time I want to go back personally as we sing this last song on this hymn of rejoicing. We have the victory. Amen. We want to thank God again for the friends, the family, and those who have come from near and far to be part of this time of celebration for Sister Jill. Amen? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Keep it true. We thank you for the life of Sister Jill. And even God, as we go, God, to put her God on the good God. Lord, we would set dust to dust as Sister Ashes. As we put it on God, we go, God, and she's with you today. We pray your blessing upon the family, upon everyone that is here. In Jesus' name. Amen. So we pray for you. So you can come to orderly fashion for those who have to sing and they want to sing. All right, 2 minutes, just 2 minutes, so you can show the place now.
Those are not simply because the case of the airport, and those are put up for a million. I can't put it better than the people who are in the airport. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Aye, no, I can't say aye, but it's coming to the body, right? Yeah, Lila Park, Clark, right? Lila, yeah. Right. Okay, so we just want to just start with a thing of for about two and then we will comment the body.
I've got my mind made up and I won't turn back, cause I want to see my Jesus someday.
And before he called Lazarus to life, Lazarus died for 4 days and was buried and was already beginning to rot. And Lazarus' sister Mary or Martha had some reservation. And Jesus told her with all assurance, I am the resurrection and the life. And not I am saying, but this is what Jesus said. I am the resurrection and the life. He that believes in me, though he dead, he will live again. And as we say earlier on, our sister have died with a hope. To be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. I say, he that believeth in me will never die. So those of us who die as in Christ, as we can look at the deceased and like she's sleeping, we just fall asleep. It's a transition from life unto life. When one receives Jesus Christ as the Lord and personal Savior, eternity begins now. Eternity begins when we are alive. When we're dead, we are not done. When we're dead, life continues. As there will sow a grain of corn and germination take place, after death, there is life. And only Jesus who was born to die in the true sense, and Jesus, only Jesus who predicted his death, not only predicted his death, but he predicted his resurrection. He said, I will die, and on the third day, I will rise again. Today, we are not here to present religion. So far, you can realize that. But we are here to present Jesus as Lord, as Savior, and our soon coming King. We die with the Lord, we will live with him in eternity. We die without the Lord, we will live without the Lord in eternity. One person said to know Jesus is to know peace. And know Jesus is no peace. To die with the Lord, you will live with him for eternity. To die without the Lord in this wicked world, we will live with him. We will live without him for the rest of eternity. So again, we want to be thankful and grateful to Almighty God for the life. Sister Neela, Master Clark have left. Right, go ahead and put it. Yeah, go ahead and put it. Go ahead and put it at the comments, buddy. Father God, we thank you. Come on, family. All the roses. Father, we thank you, God. Truly, you are the resurrection and the life. We thank you, God, for the life our sister have lived, and we continue to celebrate the life. And the memory of her will never die from us, or the memory of her will continue to live on. And we are grateful and thankful, God, for knowing her as a mother, as a friend, as a neighbor, as a sister. And for those who may not be biological children, but she was a mother to many. And Father, we thank you. Even to some of her children, she was a mother, and she was also a father. Father, we thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. Take your time to hear. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we will sing and shout the victory.
I'm gonna walk all around God's heaven. I'm gonna love those who've gone before. I'm gonna sit by the bank of the river, and when we meet, we shall part no more. Leave your burden down by the riverside. Down by the riverside. Down by the riverside. Your brothers down by the riverside, carry them no more. I said to carry them no more, carry them no more, carry them no more. I said to carry them no more, carry them no more, carry them no more.
If you want to see one of them guys, you can have two to choose them.
You can have two to choose
them. Yes, how many years? How many years?
You can have two.
Almighty God, we thank you for your goodness and we thank you for your mercy, God. We thank you, God, for the life Mira, Master Clark have lived, God. But even from her mother womb, you have formed her, God. And Lord God, you have destined the place that she have lived or the places that she have lived, you have destined for the children and the many lives that she have affected in her lifetime, my God. And this time, God, we commit the body. We know, God, according to your word, we came from the dust, and dust we shall return, my God. And Almighty God, we commit your body to you, God, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in Jesus' name, amen. Let's sing a song. Hallelujah. Come very much.
Come on, go ahead. 2 by 2. Come on, you're
steps so sweet. I am on the rock, and the rock is higher than high. Jehovah, hide me. I am on the rock. Go tell my enemies, I am on the rock.
Yeah.